God hated Esau.
Amen.
And repentance was not found. I told Sunday school class this morning that if we ain't careful, we could get ourselves in a position that we'll fall out with God.
Amen.
Somebody can take your crown from you. David almost got himself in a position where he fell out with God.
Amen.
But you know what David did? David repented.
Yes, he did.
Oh, God. David found favor.
Yes, he did.
With God. You know, sin is only pleasurable for a season.
Yes,
amen.
And that word sin means the voluntary departure of a moral agent from a known rule of rectitude or duty prescribed by God. You know, we can get ourselves there, church.
Yeah.
Sin is either a positive act when a known divine law is violated, or it is the voluntary neglect to obey a positive divine command or a rule of duty clearly implied in such command. Sin comprehends no action only, but neglects of known duty. All evil thoughts, purposes, words, desires, wherever is contrary to God's commands or law, is sin. You know, the Bible says there's one thing that will not enter in the kingdom of heaven.
Sin.
That's sin. There's only one thing that separates us from God. It's sin. Amen. That's the only thing that can separate us from the love of God. Is sin.
Amen.
You know, the one thing that I've always stuck with me when I studied about sin, you know, there is in archery, there's a term when you miss the mark.
Yes.
It's called sin.
Yes.
That's what they call it. And when I read that, it's like it went off.
Amen.
If I sin, it will cause me to miss the mark.
Yes. Yes.
What mark is that? That's the high calling of God.
Yes, amen.
Amen. That's heaven.
Amen.
Being in the presence of God, that's heaven.
Yes.
You know, I know that we're looking for a city whose builder maker is God. But we can be in heaven in this earth. Because to be in the presence of God is heavenly.
Amen.
But you know what stops us from getting there? Is sin.
Amen.
And sin is a disobedience to God's word.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
And it just does not stop with one.
Come on, brother.
Because there's normally when you sin, the first thing you start doing is lying.
Come on, brother.
You're cheating.
Amen.
Come on. I mean, it's just the way it is. You just can't commit one sin. But you got to come clean with God. But before, I want you to know this, before sin comes, a warning from God comes first.
Amen.
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 A warning from God will always come first.
Amen.
And that warning is the word of God will be presented to you.
Yes, God. Hallelujah.
That's what was presented to him, was the word of
yes,
God.
Hallelujah.
Is not this Uriah, the wife of Uriah the Hittite?
Yes.
Paul said, I do not sin, but by the law. Is the law sin? God forbid. He said, but he said, thou shalt not covet.
Come on, brother.
That's how I know sin, because the word of God discloses it to us.
Amen.
Amen. When we desire something that God even told him in Nathan. He said, Nathan, would not have I gave you such and such. He said, if all that I gave you wasn't enough, would not have I gave you more. David got to the place that his will was greater than his love for God.
Amen.
And when we get there, we're on the downhand side of victory.
Amen.
Because even Joab sent word to him after Uriah died. Joab sent word to David and told him, "We have taken the city. Now you can come down here and get the victory, or they will say this city is given into Joab's name."
Come on.
That's how I knew David got to the place he wasn't worried about the victories Joab was giving.
Come on.
So David arose and he went because he thought he had his problem taken care of. See, when you got your problems, it's hard to focus on God, ain't it?
Amen.
When you got your problems, it's hard to focus on victory, ain't it?
Amen.
See, sometimes we have problems that we should not have because we chose to do wrong.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Somebody come to this piano. Praise the Lord.
Yes, amen.
Amen. God will always send a warning, church. Amen. We just got to be willing to hear it. Amen. Praise God. Amen. These altars are open for all those who want to come. Father, I've done my best to preach what you gave me to the best of my ability. God, in my place, I want you. Father, I ask you to take me to sit here this morning. God, and you help your children. God, you help your people, Lord God. God, we thank you, God, that you'll always send us a warning, Father, before destruction comes. God, as you said, Noah, God, let us know when the flood was coming. God, as you sent the Lord, the angels, God, before the Sodom and Gomorrah were destroyed.
Oh, God.
Amen.